Jaguar XJS. This is a 1996, so end of the run. 70,000 miles and counting. Equipped with the 4-liter inline six, which in my opinion is a better option to the 12, because it will actually get you where you need to go and you're not taking a huge penalty as far as power or smoothness or anything like that. Yeah, it's down on power a little bit and smoothness a little bit from the V12, but it works and it's relatively reliable and it's relatively easy to work on. So let's take a walk around it to check it out. Pretty clean car. And importantly, nearly everything seems to work, which not always the case on these cars. A little bit of wear on the driver's seat. See the side bolsters here, show some wear. There's some creasing and splitting here on the seat bottom. This seam is no good, and this seam is no good. But it's not completely falling apart, and the rest of the leather in here is held up pretty darn well. Passenger seat looks good, rear seats look good, seat backs look good. Pretty common on these. The vinyl section right here on both sides is worn. There's a little bit of a hole. We really wanted to replace that. It's not a huge ordeal. It's simply vinyl. It's one little patch panel. So that's all good. Top is in good shape. It goes up, it goes down. We'll check that out here in a minute. One little hole worn there. Not certain what that's about. Now it does have a bit of an exhaust leak. When you're driving it, you can definitely hear it when you're giving it the beans. Not the end of the world. I peek my head under it. Looks like there's a split in the pipe right behind the cat. So that'll have to be dealt with, or just drive it as is. You're not gonna hurt anything. It's pretty far back, it's behind the cat. But it would be a little classier sounding. Get that resolved. And it should be pretty simple. Any exhaust shop worth their salt can handle that in no time. Power seat works. We're going forward, we're going backwards. Top works. What's this guy? Ooh, lumbar. I don't know if you can hear it, but it's working. Headlights. Fog lights, signal. I don't know if that means there's a bulb out, the little bulb with the X. I didn't notice that before, but there it is. It does have cruise control. Heater works, AC works. Get this guy going. There it goes. The AC works. It's getting a little cool. We'll play with it in a minute. It does have fog lights, although I don't see them on the front, so I think it's simply rear fog lights, which is kind of interesting. I've never seen just rear fogs without anything else. Oh, you know what? I heard the compressor there, so I think maybe the AC is working. We'll play with it a little bit more. Domes, although they're not really dome lights, they're and it's weird, the one on the left turns the one on the right on. Kind of odd. That one doesn't turn that one on. So that's a little goofy, but you know, Jaguar. Guy doesn't want to work. That one's going though. Let's pop the hood real quick. But before we do that, I do want to put the roof up so we can see how this guy works. Let's see. That guy's probably got to be down. Parking brake, I believe, needs to be on. There we go. Quarter glasses went up on by their own. Windows up. There we go. And then in reverse order. Ta-da-da. Sweet. All right, let's check this hood out and then go for a ride. There are some paint chips here. I think somebody maybe wasn't super careful closing the hood a couple of times. That's probably what did that, and there's a high point here. There's one on the other side too, though this one's more severe. There it is. 4-0. Basically it. There's really not a whole lot on the exterior. A little bit of damage on the bumper here. A couple of rock, little parking lot dings there. A little scuff on the bumper there. A couple of door dings. One on the body line right there, one up there. And a little scratch down here. But overall, extremely handsome car. This corner looks really good, but there is a scrape on this corner. That's pretty much it. Let's go take her for a spin, shall we? Okie dokie. Let's go for a ride in the XJS. Miles and counting. 4-liter inline six. We'll just do something real quick with it. Let's go. Thank you. Well, the people like the XJS, and it's a good looking car. It drives really strong. If you can hear it, it certainly has a little bit of an exhaust leak. Looks like there's a split in the pipe right behind the cat. Should be pretty easy repair. Probably don't even have to replace any pipe. Probably just need to buzz it down, sand it. But otherwise, wonderful car. So that's it. Bid often, bid early, and thanks for hanging out.